A convoy of military trucks passes through the northern Italian city of Bergamo. Crematorium so overwhelmed that the military is transporting the dead.
Una, due, tre.
And there are many, many dead. More have now died from COVID-19 in Italy than in all of China, where the virus first emerged. That's despite Italy having far fewer overall cases. The question, why? And what can America learn from it? In addition to sending a plane full of supplies,
if you want to say something,
Chinese have also sent the vice president of the Red Cross, who gave this explanation.
You are not having very strict lockout policy of the city because the public transportation is still working and people are still moving around and you're still having like dinners and parties in the hotels and you're not wearing masks.
Here in Rome, it's plain to see. Officials are putting ever more stringent policies in place trying to keep people home. But as you can see, there are plenty of Romans out disobeying the order.
If I stay here every day, I risk contagion. There aren't rules the people don't understand. It seems like Italians don't get it. They shouldn't stand less than a meter apart.
Lots of people are afraid. They are taking the situation very seriously. They go around in face masks and keep their distance. They try to avoid contact, while others act like nothing's happening, like it's a normal flu. They're underestimating the problem.
Italy declared its first positive cases at the end of January. The prime minister moved quickly to declare a state of emergency. But it would not be until 3 weeks later, on February 23rd, that the government started to ban public gatherings, close schools, and asked anyone who might have been exposed to self-quarantine in northern Italy, where most of the cases were at that point. Leaders sent mixed messages, even politicians posting photos of themselves out drinking cocktails in Milan. It would not be until 2 weeks after that, March 8th, that the region was put on lockdown. 233 were already dead. Marzio Toniolo is a school teacher in San Fiorano, part of the original red zone.
Qua la gente non ha mai smesso di morire.
Here people have never stopped dying. Every day it has been like this. We have a number of deaths that just keeps increasing exponentially.
Allora, partiamo dal,
A police car has just passed by. Maybe the first time I've heard this. They are asking the population to stay inside their homes.
Italy's population is older than average, and the average coronavirus victim here is just over 80. Like other European countries, testing here has not been nearly as aggressive as in countries like Korea, meaning it's been much harder to trace the infection. And as the center of the first contagion in Europe, its hospitals were immediately overwhelmed. At first, Italy's government counted on people to do the right thing. Now they make sure they do.
There's a high level of contagion, and we're not even counting the dead anymore. Look at the news that's coming out of Italy and take note of what the situation really is like. It's unimaginable.
Take heed. Barbie Nadeau, CNN, Rome.